what you are about to receive, may the Lord make you truly grateful.
I could not find you. Liberal terms. £3, please.
As a matter of fact, I was eating a boy.
Well, then it's settled. One parochial apprentice. £3.
You don't mind cash upon liking, Mr. Bumble. Cash upon liking.
Mrs. Sowerberry.
What is it?
Oliver, pull that cap off your eyes and hold up your head, sir.
Well, what do you want? What is it? Oh, Mr. Bumble!
My dear, I've been considering taking this boy to help in the shop.
Dear me, he's very small.
He is rather small. There's no denying it. But he'll grow, Mrs. Sowerberry. He'll grow.
I dare say he will in our vittles and our drink. These workhouse boys, they're a waste of time. They always cost more to keep than what they're worth. But still, you men always think you know best.
There's an expression of melancholy on his face, which is very interesting. It would make a delightful coffin follower. Not for the regular practice, but only for the children's. It would be very novel to have a following proportion.
Yes, it's a possibility. Very well then, boy, what's your name?
Oliver Twist, ma'am.
Huh, a singular name.
I, ma'am, and one of my own choosing.
Yours, Mr. Bumble.
Mine, Mrs. Sowerberry. We name our foundlings in alphabetical order. The last one was an S. Swubble, I named him. This was a T. Twist, I named him.
An orphan, then, Mr. Bumble.
Indeed, Mrs. Sowerberry. The lad's mother came to us destitute. Brings the child into the world, takes one look at him, and promptly dies without leaving so much as a forwarding name and address.
Very well then, Oliver Twist. Do you think you can look like that gentleman up there?
Maybe. Perhaps if I had a tall hat.
Never mind about tall hats.
The boy is quite right. These things must be done proper and correct. Get the boy a tall hat. Stand underneath the picture, boy.
Perfect. Very becoming.
Yes, yes. But one time you might have had a decent idea. Do you think you could keep that expression for a while, boy? With the crowd watching you?
Yes, ma'am. I think so.
He's a born undertaker's mute. I can see him in his black silk suit. Following behind the funeral procession with his features fixed in a suitable expression. There'll be horses with tall black plumes to escort us to the family tombs, with mourners in our corners who will talk to weep in tune.
When the coffin lined with satin, that's your funeral, that's your funeral, large enough to wave your hats in, that's your funeral, that's your funeral. Just here to glamorize you for bed endlessly. You might just as well look fetching when you're 6 feet deep. At the wake, we'll drink the tarty to the body beautiful.
That's your funeral.
No, it's our funeral.
That's your funeral. By under-eating, that's your funeral.
That's your funeral. Visualize the earth descending on you quad by quad. You can't come back when you're buried underneath the sod. We will not reduce our prices. Keep your vices usual.
That's your funeral.
No, it's our funeral.
That's your funeral.
That's your funeral.
Funeral.
Dana to eat him. Aw, your boy. Charlotte, this is the new boy. Give them to him. Charlotte, don't just stand there. Pull down the blinds. Henry, get to bed.
It's a pub effect the more I think about it.
Have you done?
Yes, ma'am.
Good, the dog's about to have a mess. Now then, Oliver Twist, you bend underneath the counter. You don't mind sleeping among coffins, I suppose. Well, it doesn't much matter whether you do or don't. You can't sleep nowhere else.
Your mother was a regular right down battle.
What did you say?
It's a good thing she died when she did too, or else she'd been trampled in Australia Island, or hung from a gym in a snake as not.
John, help the new boy run to me!
Come to think of it, I've got no friends. Still, what's the difference? You're coming with me.
Are you sure Mr. Fagin won't mind?
Mind? Consider yourself at home. Consider yourself one of the family. We've taken you so strong. It's clear we're going to get along. Consider yourself well in. Consider yourself part of the furniture. There isn't a lot to spare. Who cares what ever we got we share? If it's your chance to be, we should see some harder days. Empty harder days. Why grouse? Always a chance we'll meet somebody to put the bill. Then the drinks are on the outs. Consider yourself a mate. We don't want to have no fuss. For after some consideration, we can stay. Consider yourself one of us. Consider yourself
at home.
Consider yourself
part of the family.
Nobody tries to be Lionel or a pity. There's a cup of tea.
your intimate acquaintance. We're very glad to see you, Oliver. Very. Aren't we, my dear?
Yes.
Mr. Trustey's come to London to seek his fortune.
You've come to London to seek your fortune. We must see what we can do to help you. Are you hungry?
Starving.
Would you like a sausage? Charlie, get the sausages. Dodger, draw up a chair near the fire for Oliver.
Dear Fagin, these sausages are mouldy. Oh.
Shut up and drink your gin. you're staring at the pocket handkerchiefs. There are quite a few of them, ain't there? We've just hung them out. They're ready for the wash. Wash. That's all, Oliver. That's all.
Is this a laundry then, sir?
Well, not exactly, my dear. I suppose a laundry would be a very nice thing indeed. But our line of business pays a bit better. Don't it, kids?
Not all.
You see, Oliver.
In this life, one thing counts. In the bank, large amounts. I'm afraid these don't grow on trees. You've got to pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two.
Show all of that how to do it, my dears. Why should we break our backs stupidly paying tax? Better get some untaxed income. Better pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two. Crime doesn't pay. Robin Hood, what a crook, gave away what he took. Charity's fine, subscribe to mine. Get in and pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two. From Bill Sykes, he can whip what he likes. I recall he started small, he had to pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two. Passing by, something nice takes his eye. Everything's clear, let's have the rear. Get in and pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two. Rich, both my thumbs start to itch, only to find some peace of mind. I have to pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two.
Himself?
Yeah, but don't
lose
my hands.
You be quiet, Charlie.
And what have you got for me, my dear?
Nose rabbits.
Well, they're very good ones. Very. You haven't embroidered the initials too well, though, Charlie. So they'll have to be picked up with a needle, won't they?
Of course.
You'll need to learn to do that too, won't you, kids? And you'll have to learn to make wallets, like Dodger and Charlie here. Make him your models, my dear. Especially Dodger. He's gonna be a right little Bill Sykes.
Who's Bill Sykes, Mr. Fagin?
All in good time, Oliver. All in good time. Now then, tell me, can you see my silk handkerchief, what is protruding from my pocket?
Yes, sir.
See if you can take it from me without my noticing it, like you saw the others did. Tum, 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 pom, 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 pom. Skittily, I tear right, tight, tight, skir up a tupper up a tum, tum. You've got to pick a pocket or two, boys. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Is it gone?
Yes, sir. It's in my hand.
I don't believe it! You're a clever boy, Oliver. I never saw a sharper lad. Here is a shilling for you. I have to go to the bank. Now bedtime, all of you. I'll start singing again.
Where shall I sleep, sir?
Here, my dear, by the trunk. I'll get you a nightcap.
Yes, please.
We're out of cocoa. Have a drop of gin. All right, settle down. Dodger, take your hat off in bed. Where's your manners? Yes, Oliver, you're quite the gentleman now. You've got a home, a profession, a shilling, on credit. If you go on this way, you'll be the greatest gentleman of all time. People are trying to sleep around here. Where's the common decency? I'll have to give him a piece of my mind, I will. Bill! What a pleasure to see you! Can I help you? Bill? Bill, how did you get on? A silver candlestick. Very nice. It's a shame we haven't got a pair. We have got a pair. They're very fine. A spoon. Solid silver. It's a shame we haven't got a knife and fork. That's beautiful, Bill. That's not so beautiful. Bill, a ring. Why, this is all so sudden. I'll see what I can get for it.
Gosh.
Pearls, Bill. And you washed them too.
Come on, Fagin. Hand it over.
Keep cash. What, Bill, keep cash around here with all these other thieves lying about? I wouldn't dare.
Fagin.
I got to price the stuff first. Proper and correct. Usual place tomorrow, the three cripples. It's a promise. It's a promise, Bill.
It better be.
My dear, you make it all worthwhile. Pearl, my pretty,
I am an extra special lady. An extra special place for you with all my other extra special lady friends. Pearl, you'll like it here. Pearl, you must meet Ruby. Ruby, this is Pearl. Pearl, this is Ruby. Pearl, you must meet Crystal. Crystal, this is Pearl. Pearl, this is Crystal. Pearl, you must meet my extra special lady friend, Tiara. One day, Tiara and I shall go out together. And I will wear my very special choker. Very nice. We shall go to the opera. I can use my beautiful opera glasses. I shall look at all the rich people and to all of the poor people.
Ah! What are you two, you awake? What have you seen? Quick, speak. I want to hear every detail you saw.
I'm sorry, sir. I couldn't sleep.
Were you awake a quarter of an hour ago?
No.
10 minutes ago?
I don't think so.
Be sure.
I'm sure.
Well then, if you're sure, I'm sure. Of course, I know all along, my dear. I only tried to frighten you. Did you see any of those pretty things, my dear?
Yes, sir.
They're mine, Oliver. My private property. It's all I've got to live on in the old age. It's a terrible thing, Oliver. Old age.
Do you think I can get up now, sir?
Certainly. There's a basin of water over there. You can go have a wash.
But I had a wash yesterday.
Well, today's your birthday. Wash!
Plumbing and slam.
Nancy!
Come on, Bet.
It's Nancy. Wake up, kids. The ladies are here.
Ladies? Go, Arkadin. We'll have less of that if you don't mind. Where's the gin, Fagin?
All in moderation, my dear. All in moderation. Too much gin can be a dangerous thing to a young girl.
And what's wrong with a bit of danger then, Mr. Fagin? After all, that's only a bit of excitement we have. And who can deny us that small pleasure? Small pleasures, who would deny us these?
Not me!
Gin, toddies, large measures, no skimping if you please. I rough it, I love it, life is a game of chance. I never tire of it, leading this merry dance. If you don't mind having a go without things, it's a fine life, though it ain't all jolly or pleasure outings. It's a fine life, it's a fine life, when you've got someone to love. You forget your cares and strife. Let the prunes look down on us, let the wide world frown on us. It's a fine, fine life. Ain't that right, Ben?
Yeah, that's right, Nancy.
Bring the plague in. It's a fine life, it's a fine life. But the grass is green and dense on the right side of the fence. And we take good care of it, and we get our share of it, and we don't need pence. If you don't mind having a life for a lumping, it's a fine, it's a fine life. Though there's no tea sipping, I need it crumb.
It's a fine life.
Oliver Twist, Esquire.
Sure. Pleased to meet you, I'm sure.
Oh, yes. We're all ladies and gentlemen here. We're all a quality.
Oh, yes.
Don't you take no notice of Oliver just because you've got manners and they ain't. You wouldn't know quality if you saw it, none of you. Don't you?
Yeah. Have you seen the way them quality gentlemen treat their babies?
Of course I have.
Shall we show them how it's done?
Definitely.
Go on, Nancy. Give us a free show.
First go the doctor's all bowing and that's soft.
Don't let your petticoats dangle in the mud, my darling.
I'll go last.
No, I'll go last.
Love him so, we'll come back home in oh such a great big hurry.
of pockets, handkerchiefs. And you should leave for the thieves. Whip it quick and be back soon. There's a sixpence here for 20. Ain't that a lovely tune? Be back soon.
Our pockets will hold a watch of gold that chimes upon the hour.
A wallet fat and old man's hat.
The crown jewels from the tower.
We know the mystery crown it, but they don't know the still.
So go picking up the picture,
we'll be back soon.
We must disappear, won't be back here.
Time to know so fast.
sights.
This near it, nobody mentions my name. Rich men hold their 5-pound notes, so saves me emptying the coat, so they know I could tear the throat, so just to live up to my name with me, Jimmy and beyond. Let me see the man who dares stop me taking what I may. He can start to say his prayers. Biceps like an iron girder, fit for doing of a murder. If I so much as ever heard a bloke even whisper my name, Phil Sykes. Some toff, slimming with his valet, bumped into me in the alley. Now his eyes are never tally, he never heard of my name. One bloke used to boast the claim he could say my name in vain. Poor bloke, shame he was so green, and never was he seen again. What's bad? What's the good turning? In hell I'll be there a burning. Meanwhile, think of what I'm earning, all on account of my name. What is it? What is it? What is it? My name!
There's still a chance we might get him back, without suspicion. We'll nab him the very moment he dares step out of that house. Now who's gonna go?
I suppose it'll have to be me.
You shut your trap, Dodger. You caused enough trouble. It's got to be done quiet. We don't want any fuss. The very thing. Nancy, my dear, you're so good with the boy.
It's no good trying it on with me.
And just what do you mean by that remark?
What I say to you, I'm not going. I can't leave the boy alone, he won't see him, Mom. I can't leave him where he is, or have a chance at a decent life.
You'll get him back, you my girl, unless you want to feel my hands on your throat.
Nancy, my dear, if he talked, think of what happened to us. Think of what happened to Bill. It'd be the gallows for him, Nancy, the The gallows. You wouldn't let that happen, wouldn't you, my dear? Not to Bill. Not to your Bill. She'll go, Fagin.
No, she won't, Fagin.
Yes, she will, Fagin. Out, all of you!
All right, Ben. Go home. That's a good girl.
As long as he needs me. Oh, yes, he does need me. In spite of what you see, I'm sure that he needs me. Who else would love him still when they've been used so well? He knows I always will. As long as he needs me, I miss him so much when he's gone. But when he's near me, I don't let on. The way I feel inside, the love I've got to hide, the hell I've got. Needs me. I know where I must be.
Mrs. Bevan.
Mr. Brownell.
How do you feel today, my boy?
Very happy, sir. May I stay here always, sir?
If you wish, dear boy, if you wish. Here's the doctor to come and see you.
Well, you still ain't looking better, but you're still not sleeping well, are you?
Oh, yes. I sleep very well, sir.
Ah, bad dreams, though, I have no doubt. Nightmares, eh?
No, sir. I don't have dreams.
Thought so, but you're hungry, aren't you?
No, doctor.
No, you're not hungry. Not thirsty, are you? Why, if that boy's thirsty, I'll eat my head.
Yes. I was rather thirsty.
Just as I expected. It's quite natural that he'd be thirsty. You may give him a little tea.
Thank you, Doctor. May I get up now?
Say ah.
Ah.
I think you may. And take a little fresh air. Don't let him be too warm, but also be sure that it doesn't get too cold. Will you have the goodness?
Certainly, Doctor.
You'll be glad to be up again, Oliver.
Do I wear these?
Well, you can't wear your old ones. They've gone in the furnace. Hurry now.
He's a fine looking boy, don't you think, Grimwig?
Couldn't tell you. I only knew two sorts of boys. Mealy boys and deep-faced boys.
And which is Oliver?
Mealy? Where does he come from?
You know, I haven't the faintest idea. He was arrested for stealing my pocket handkerchief. And when the shopkeeper told him what had really happened, he was released by the magistrate. I brought him here to make him amends I could, but I must confess, I found myself strangely attached to the boy.
He's deceiving you, my friend. He has had a fever. What does that? Fevers are not peculiar to good people, are they? Bad people have fevers too, don't they? He saw your pocket handkerchief, didn't he? Now steal some more, sir. What do you know of him? Nothing.
Only that he's an orphan. And yet, it's strange. There's something in that boy's face. Somewhere I've seen him before. Somewhere I'm wrong, time ago.
Stuff and nonsense, you're imagining things.
Yes, what is it?
The bookseller, sir.
Ah, yes, thank you. Now, I've got to give you some. Hey, wait a moment. Oh, I really, really, really particularly wish for some books to be returned today.
Why not send Oliver with them?
Oh, yes. Do let me take them for you, please, sir.
Oh, very well. Very well, my boy. Very well. If you wish, you shall. Now, here's what you're going to do. We'll give Mr. Jessup these books. It's just down the road. Say you've come to pay the £4.10 that I owe him. Here's £5. No need to rush, but I shall expect you back here in 10 minutes.
10 minutes. No need to rush.
She's a very pretty lady, isn't she, sir?
Yes. It's a portrait of my daughter Agnes.
I'll take the books then, sir.
Yes, you take the books.
Ha! You don't really expect him to return, do you? Well, with a new suit of clothes on his back and a 5-pound ring in his pocket? My dear Mr. Brownell, if he does, I'll eat my head.
Dr. Gilman, take a look at the portrait. Don't you see an extraordinary resemblance between Oliver and my daughter Agnes?
Can't say I do.
Well, in 10 minutes, when the boy returns, I think you will see.
Yes, Mr. Brownlow. 10 minutes.
So sunny, it could not happen twice.
let go, Nancy!
Oh, Oliver, my dear little brother, where have you been? We've been worried out of our heads.
What's the matter, love?
Oh, he ran away 2 weeks ago from his parents, who are hard-working, respectable people, and went and joined a set of thieves and bad characters, almost broke his mother's heart.
It's not true!
We don't fret! Don't tell me, little girl.
I'm not! I haven't any mother or father! I'm an orphan!
Oh, heavens, just listen to him!
Beth, tell them to let me go!
See, he knows his little sister. He can't hide that. Make him come home or he'll kill us!
What the devil's all this?
Young old,
come home to your poor mother, you young dog. Come on home. What? Books too? You've been stealing again, haven't you? He's nothing but a thief and a vagabond.
That's right, that's what he needs.
Help! I don't belong there!
Now, you little leader, you're coming with us.
All right, Bill.
Say goodbye to your fancy living.
Leave him, Bill!
Come home again, have you, Oliver, my dear?
Look at his thoughts, Fagin!
He's got books too. Quite the little gent, isn't he?
Delighted to see you looking so well, my dear. The artful dodger shall give you a new suit, for fear you shall spoil that Sunday one. Why didn't you write, my dear, and say you were coming? We'd have got something warm for supper.
Cool. Look at this!
Hello, what's that? That's mine, Fagin.
No, no, my dear. Mine. You can have the books.
Well, if that ain't mine, mine and Nancy's, that is, I'll take the boy back again.
This is hardly fair, Bill. Hardly fair, is it, Nancy?
Well, fair, not fair. Hand it over, you avaricious old skeleton. Give it here. That's for our share of the trouble, not half of it neither. Here, you can have the books. Start a library.
You can't have the books or the money. They belong to Mr. Brownlow. And if he finds out you've got them, he'll be down here after you.
So he'll be down here, will
he? Leave him alone, Bill.
What did you tell him about us?
Nothing!
That remains to be seen. But if we find out you've said anything out of line, Fagin all the way to the end, scoundrels told him everything.
Ow!
Hit me, would you?
No, leave him alone, too!
Stand off me or I'll split your head open!
Go on, then kill me. You'll have to before I let you lay a hand on that boy.
Stay out of this, Nancy, I'm warning you!
All right. We've got the boy back. What's the matter with him?
Girl's gone mad, I think, Fagin.
Don't think it, Fagin.
Then keep quiet, William. All of this violence.
What did you tell him about us?
I won't stand by and see
it done, Bill. Why, Nancy, you're wonderful tonight. Such talent. What an actress.
Am I? Take care I don't overdo it. Because if I do, I'm going to leave my mark on some of you, and I don't care if I hang for it.
You? Do you know who you are and what you are?
Oh, yes, I know all about it. You don't have to tell me.
Find one for the boy to make a friend of you are.
Lord, help me, I am. I wish I'd been struck down dead before I laid a hand in bringing the boy back. After tonight, he's a liar and a thief and all that's bad. Ain't that enough for you, the beating him to death?
Come, Nancy. We must have civil words. Civil words, Bill.
Civil words? Yes, you deserve them from me. I was out on the streets for you and I was a child half his age, in the same trade, the same service, 15 years since, and don't you forget it.
Well, what if you were? It's your living, ain't it?
Some living!
Take care of her, Bill. Take care of him, Dodger.
I'll take care of myself. A man's got a heart, hasn't he? Joking apart, hasn't he? And though I'd be the first one to say that I wasn't a saint, I'm finding it hard to be really as black as they paint. I'm reviewing the situation. Can a fellow be a villain all his life? All the trials and tribulation. Better settle down and get myself a wife. And a wife would cook and sew for me, and come for me, and go for me, and go for me, and knock at me. The finger she will wag at me, the money she will take from me, a misery she'll make for me. I think I'd better think it out again.
Are you gonna sit there snoring all day? going to sit here as long as I think proper, madam. And although I was not snoring, I shall snore, gape, sneeze, laugh, or cry as the humour strikes me, such being my prerogative.
Your prerogative!
I said the word, ma'am. The prerogative of a man is to command.
And what's the prerogative of a woman in the name of goodness?
To obey, madam, to obey. Your late unfortunate husband should have taught you that. And then perhaps he might have been alive today. And I wish he was. Poor man.
Oh, you are not a brute.
Oh, here we go. Cry away. It opens the lungs, exercises the eyes, softens the temper, and washes the face. So cry away.
Now stop him on your prerogative if you dare! Shut up and take yourself away from me unless you want me to do something desperate! Well, are you going?
Certainly, my dear, certainly. It's just that you're so very violent.
What's the matter?
It's old Sally, ma'am. She says she's got something to tell you that must be heard. She's not got long, and she'll never die quiet if you don't listen to her.
You better come in.
I once nursed a pretty young creature that I brought in from the coast. With her feet cut and bruised with walking, she gave birth to a boy and died. Let me think, what was the year again?
Never mind the year, what about her?
I robbed her, so I did. It was the only thing she had of any worth. It was round her neck and it was gold.
Gold? Go on, yes, what of it?
This is it, this locket. She charged me to keep it safe and trusted me. It's my belief she came from a rich family.
The boy's name?
They called him...
Yes?
Oliver, the goat I stole was...
Yes, what? We must retrieve that boy, Mr. Bumble.
We must indeed, ma'am. Must
in the
All in that was the man with the larger but sign.
All in apparently he's from a rich family.
And the thing we knew, he stupidly went and lost track of him.
If the truth were known, we'd both be delighted at seeing the back of him.
Given to my dear wife by the lad's dying mother just before she passed away. The lad's dying mother, that is, not my wife.
You say when he left the workhouse, he went to an undertaker's?
Yes, Mr. Sowbury, the undertaker, took Oliver from us for £3.
You mean to say you sold him? Like an animal?
Well, it was Mrs. Bumble who actually authorized the sale.
Really? Then I see that neither of you is employed in a position of trust again. And your behavior, madam, is shameful. Leave my house.
Oh, how dare you speak so
come to me, sir. I came here to help you.
You came here in hopes of profiting from your own greed and dishonesty.
Well, if you consider the trinket don't properly belong to my dear wife...
Shut up, you old fool!
Here, £10. Take it and consider yourself fortunate that you don't find yourselves in the hands of the law. Mrs. Bedwin, show these ghastly people out.
Yes, sir.
We know the way out. Thank you very much.
I hope, sir, this unfortunate little circumstance won't deprive me of my parochial office.
Indeed it will. And you may see yourself well off besides.
Well, it was all Mrs. Bumble. She would do it.
That is no excuse. You were present on the occasion on which the boy was sold. And indeed, all are guilty of the two. For the law supposes that your wife acts under your direction.
Well, if the law supposes that, the law is an ass. And if that's the eye of the law, then the law is a bachelor. And the worst I wish upon the law is that his eye may be opened by experience.
There's a young woman inquiring to see you, sir.
Mrs. Bedham, take a look at this miniature. Can you see who it is?
Why, it's Miss Agnes, sir.
Yes, my daughter Agnes. She must have found her way to the workhouse and had a child there.
If only she had told us.
Mrs. Bedham, who is this?
It's about the boy, sir.
Have you news of Oliver?
Yes, he's in danger, bad company. He got taken off the day you sent him out with them books.
Who took him?
Me and someone else.
Where can I find him? Who is this other person you speak of? Take me to him.
No, I can't. I shouldn't have said that.
Now come, sit down. You want to help the boy, don't you? Why else are you here?
I do, but...
Then at least tell me where I can find him.
I can't, but I can bring him to you. Not here, it's too far.
Where then?
The bridge, London Bridge, tonight, at midnight. And you've got to come alone. Promise me you'll come on your own. I'll find a way of bringing him to you. You don't believe me, do you? Well, if you want Oliver back, then you've got to believe me.
Very well. I'll be there.
Thank God!
Wait. Has the boy been hurt? Ill-treated? If so, I shall...
No, I can't say no more. Please. He'll kill me as it is if he finds out where I've been.
Who is this man? Perhaps we can...
No! We can't. Whatever I do, I won't turn my back on him. I understand, my dear.
And the man who might kill you.
Yes, but he's mine. And I'm his. I've got to go back. I want to go back. Do you think we can trust her, Mr. Brownlow?
I'm afraid we have no choice, Mrs. Bedwin.
away, would you?
No, not you, Bill, never you!
Get away from me, woman!
No, I won't let go, Bill. Look at me! Look at me! I've been trading you upon my soul, I have!
Get away
no,
from
please.
Me!
Bill! Bill, no! Bill, please!
One boy, quick! Stand up! Stand up!
No!
Shut up! Go up the stairs!
No. Stop!
Quick,
please.
Faster!
I said, get. Oh my God. Oh my, help, help! There's been a murder.
Nancy.
I just came here to meet this poor creature.
Nancy, somebody murdered Nancy.
It was a large, heavily built man.
Anything else?
He wore a black coat and carried a heavy cudgel.
Bill Sykes! What's going on? It's Nancy! Bill Sykes has killed Nancy!
What will you
mean? He'll be invading! Go
ahead! Let's go!
Fagin! Fagin!
What is it, Bill? What have you done?
The game's up, Fagin.
No, Bill, not Nancy. You haven't. Run, kids, run!
Fagin, what do I do?
Live up to your name. Go to bat.
Oh, me hat! Who do you think you are laying your hands on? Assault and battery, that's what it is? Waking a respectful man up in the early hours of the morning? Shame on you!
I'll turn a leaf over, and who can tell what I may find?